Hey there everyone, welcome to practice. Today's class is all about exploring dynamic and static variations in our downward facing dog. These variations will help improve strength, endurance, flexibility in the hamstrings whilst opening the chest and shoulders, which can help reverse posture damage from slouching, along with improving blood circulation. Expect a good upper body workout and blood flow to the head. Alright, let's start in a wide child's pose, big distance between the thighs, big toes touch behind and torso rests in between the thighs with the hands walked out as far forward as possible. Let's use this moment to gently introduce lateral expansion to the chest with every inhale. First and foremost, driving all our awareness to the breath. Now allow the lower body to stay as is. Walk the hands out to the left, placing the right palm on the left palm. Come back into the center and walk the hands out to the right, placing the left palm on the right this time. Come back into the center, prop yourself up into a seat, Vajrasana, and let's move through a few neck rotations to either side, linking breath with movement always. Inhale as the head drops back and exhale as the head drops forward. Now if taking full rotations is too much for you, please feel free to rock the head from side to side. Coming back into the center, pick the hands up and let's move through a few wrist rotations to one side since we are going to be on them a lot. Switch the direction and then shake out the palms. Now plant your palms coming into a tabletop position. As you inhale, arch the back, gaze up for cow pose. Exhale, pick the knees off the mat for downward facing dog, doing those four more times. Now on your last exhale, come into a downward facing dog and begin to pedal the feet here on every exhale. Bend one knee at a time, pushing the chest open towards the bent thigh. Now let's hold our downward facing dog, preparing the body to get used to holding this posture. All right, big inhale, exhale, step forward. Inhale, half forward fold. Exhale, full forward fold. Inhale, swing the arms and gaze up to the sky. Exhale, hands near heart center. Inhale, swing the arms and gaze up to the sky. Exhale, circle the arms down for a full forward fold. Inhale, half lift, flat back. Exhale, plant the palms, hopper step to plank pose. Drop the entire body down to the mat. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, come into a high plank. Exhale, tap the right fingertips to the left ankle or shin. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, repeat on the other side. Few more rounds to go, just like that. And on your next inhale, come into a high plank. Exhale as you grab the right outer ankle or shin with the left hand holding here. Inhale, come back into a high plank. Exhale, downward dog twist to the other side. Release, coming into a downward facing dog. Inhale. Exhale, hopper step forward. Inhale, half forward fold. Exhale, full forward fold. Inhale, stand to rise. Exhale, hands near heart center. Inhale, swing the arms up to the sky. Exhale, circle the arms down for full forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, hopper step back to plank pose. Drop the entire body down to the mat. Inhale, cobra pose. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now lift the left foot, place it on the right ankle. Holding here. This can be an intense stretch for your hamstrings. So know when a funky, uneasy feeling arises within you and remember to not push your limit to a breaking point. Keep pushing your right heel towards the mat, feeling an extra stretch even in your calves. Now release and switch sides. Inhale, come back into a high plank position. Exhale, drop the body to the mat. This time inhale, cobra pose or modified upward facing dog with the knees on the mat. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now as you inhale, kick the left leg up. Hold here. Ekapada Adomukha Svanasana or one-legged dog. Now it can be really tempting to lift the right heel off the mat in order to lift the left leg higher. But keep your hips squared, right heel glued to the mat, and the left foot flexed. Keep breathing. Gently release and switch sides. Now drop the leg back to the mat. Inhale, exhale, hopper step forward. Inhale, half forward fold. Exhale, full forward fold. Inhale, swing the arms and gaze up to the sky. Exhale, hands near heart center. Inhale, swing the arms up to the sky. Exhale, circle the arms down for full forward fold. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, full fold. Plant the palms, hop or step back to plank pose. Drop the entire body to the mat. Taking a back bend of your choice on an inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, high plank. Exhale, drop the body to the mat. Inhale, cobra pose or modified upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Doing those four more times, starting with our high plank. Dropping the body to the mat. Coming into cobra or up dog. And then coming back into downward facing dog. Three more rounds to go on your own. Now, once you're done, end in a child's pose for a little break. Perfect. Plant the palms and on an exhale, pick yourself up into downward facing dog. Pick the left leg, place the left ankle on the right knee. Come onto the right toes, bend the knee as you push the torso towards the thighs. Figure 4 in downward facing dog. Gently release and switch sides. Perfect. Now drop the leg back to the mat. Inhale, exhale, hop or step forward. Inhale, half fold. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, stand to rise. Exhale, hands near heart center. All right, we have our last two variations to go. Inhale as you swing the arms up to the sky. Exhale, circle the arms down, full forward fold. Inhale, flat back. Half lift, exhale, hop or step back to plank pose. Drop the entire body down to the mat. Inhale, cobra or upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, high plank. Exhale as you come onto the forearms. Inhale, push back into dolphin pose. Exhale, forearm plank. Inhale, dolphin pose. Exhale, forearm plank, doing a few more rounds with that breathing pattern. And on the last one, drop yourself down to Sphinx pose. Use your palms and elbows to keep pulling your chest open. Plant the palms near the chest and lift off to downward facing dog. Now lift the left leg off the mat with the right hand to facing back. Holding this little balancing posture in our downward facing dog. Absolutely okay if you fall out. That's why it's called a yoga practice or an asana practice. Well done, release. And then let's switch sides. One side is always more funkier than the other. Don't close your eyes and gaze at one point. Awesome. Gently release into child's pose. This time, hands in line with the body. Now pick yourself up into Vajrasana, giving your shoulders a few backward rotations. Reverse the direction to forward. Pick the hands up, taking a few wrist rotations in one direction. Switch the direction and then shake out the palms. Perfect. Now as you inhale, drive the arms up to the sky. Exhale, Vajrasana, twist to the right. Use the left palm placed out of the right knee to twist a little deeper. Your right palm is either placed on a block behind you or on the mat. Inhale as you come back into the center. Exhale, twist to the left. Now let's come back into the center. Inhale as you interlock the fingers. Flip the palms to facing the ceiling. Gaze up. Exhale, bring the arms down in line with the shoulders. Hunch the upper back. Two more times, just like that. Now gently release the legs from under you and lie yourself down in Shavasana. Hands away from the body, palms facing the ceiling, legs dropped to either side. Big inhale through the nose and long sigh through the mouth. Relax. Feel the body get heavier on the mat on every exhale. Be aware of your surroundings, be aware of all the sounds around you. Without trying to be inquisitive of the source of that sound. If you are unable to hold the mind still, allow your thoughts to keep rotating like a movie card, allowing them to fade naturally. Hear yourself breathe, and maybe even repeat the word relax mentally to yourself. To help the mind settle. Keep your exhalations a little longer than your inhalations. And please feel free to stay here for as long as you like. We have come to the end of class. Thank you so much for joining me in practice today. Please don't forget to like this video if it has helped you, and subscribe to my channel to continue practicing with me. I will see you soon. Have a lovely day.